a lot of the imagery and of the symbolism that I've worked with and used throughout my years stems from the background, you know, that I was raised in, which is my background or my heritage is Navajo. I'm Navajo. Grew up in a family that was very isolated. Nobody spoke English. English is my second language. We didn't, you know, really grew up with churches. We didn't have, Catholic churches nearby, you know, that would influence us. So we I grew up pretty much with the traditional way of looking at the world, which was if you got sick and something was wrong, it meant that psychically you were falling, you know, out of rhythm or tune with nature. And so you went about restoring that healing by, you know, surrounding yourself with beauty and with nature that would, you know, set you back on the correct path. And you know, that was the core of the teaching I grew up with. So that applies to my paintings. I've always worked with a very with landscape, with calming landscape. It's the sense of you know, the of being in a particular place on this earth. You can kind of feel the earth moving, you know, the skies shifting when you look at the works. There's little activity of plant life, little activity of, you know, what occurred during the night, little feet patterns that you might see in the works. The shading, the sky, you know, that the sky casts the shade on the earth. That's kind of what you see. You know, I've always been very fascinated by how, you know, all this activity happens from day, you know, from dawn to dusk. And that's what I've always worked with. I make up a lot of the things, you know, the little seed pods, the little water worlds, the little topography of how, you know, the hills raise up. You're looking down at those things. That's what I'm looking at, you know, the little minute details that people don't notice. And that's what my work has always been about.